Scope storage was another thing that was included in Android 10, and it's going to be mandatory in Android 11. Why does that matter? Well, scope storage is really interesting. I think it created a new challenge in terms of how to look at Android application data access. For those of you who aren't familiar, I did write up a nice little short blog about this. Check it out. But basically, you know, external storage on Android isn't the best place to store sensitive information. It's a common place developers go to and use, and sometimes it's a permission that gets added in an application extraneously and isn't necessary. And Android, I think, is very well aware of that, because in Android 10, they implemented this thing called scope storage. And scope storage basically required you to kind of consider, do you really need this permission? Is it something that's necessary? If it is, you know, you're going to have to do some things. You're going to have to jump through some hoops to get that permission. But really, in most cases, people don't need access to all the external storage, only the external storage associated with your app. And in addition to that, you know, there are other applications that still can access that, but only in special criteria. So in Android 10, it wasn't mandatory, but in Android 11, it is going to be mandatory now. Right now, your Android 10 apps or Android 9 apps that are about to start targeting Android 10 might be using this flag called Request Legacy External Storage. Now it's going to be Preserve Legacy External Storage flag. But in general, you're not supposed to use that flag. The other thing too is there's a permission associated with it. It used to be read-write storage. You might be familiar with the external storage permissions. They've changed names so many times, but now it's becoming manage external storage. So if your application is running and you see, you maybe have an app vetting program and you're looking at the other apps on users' devices, the commonly used ones, be aware of that manage external storage permission, that preserved legacy external storage flag, because really you're going to get penalized for using those. There's a lot of things that can happen to your app if you target it, you know, early on, and then later on transition, it might kind of mess up users' experiences a little bit. But also, the only apps that really should be using that are really specific, like edge cases, like an application that shares data from your device back to some backend or something else, where you have a document management system app on your device that has to access external storage, and all app storage that's on external storage. Again, check out the blog, kind of read up on external storage, because it isn't the best place to store sensitive data, or just data where integrity really matters.